Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. Aung San Suu Kyi faces additional charges as Burmese security forces unleash brutal crackdown. Arrests and injuries reported following protests outside Thai Prime Minister's residence. Iran refuses proposed talks with US and European Union until sanctions are revoked. Mass protests against imperialism and dictatorship continue across Haiti. Ousted Burmese State Councillor Aung San Suu Kyi is facing two additional charges following a hearing on March 1st. She has been charged under Section 505B of the Criminal Code related to incitement to, quote, commit an offence against the state. The second charge is related to a violation under Myanmar's telecommunication law for using equipment without a license. Both charges reportedly carry a combined prison sentence of up to 3 years. Suu Kyi was previously charged for breaching COVID-19 regulations and violating import-export laws. As reported by Myanmar Now, ousted President Win Myint has also been charged for incitement under the country's penal code. The next round of hearings has been scheduled for March 15th. Suu Kyi has reportedly been unable to meet with her lawyers and has been moved to an undisclosed location by the military junta. Monday's hearing took place a day after Myanmar witnessed the most brutal crackdown on protesters since the coup on February 1st. At least 18 people were killed and over 30 were wounded after security forces fired live rounds into the crowd at several sites. The UN Human Rights Office reported deaths in 6 cities, including Yangon and Mandalay, on February 28. Tear gas and stun grenades were also deployed in several places as security forces arrested protesters. The Assistance Association for Political Prisoners has reported that 1,132 people have been detained since the coup. Despite the violence on Sunday, protests continued across several cities on March 1st. Police forces deployed tear gas and stun grenades to disperse the crowds. Myanmar Now reported that police forces had also fired guns while patrolling the streets in Yangon. The extent of casualties is unconfirmed at the time of recording this episode. At least 16 people were injured during a protest outside the residence of Thailand's Prime Minister in Bangkok on February 28. Protesters gathered outside the military barracks of the residence were attacked with tear gas, water cannons and batons. Local news portal Prachatai also reported eyewitness accounts of police deploying rubber bullets. Police have reportedly also arrested at least 22 protesters, including 4 minors. According to reports, at least 2,000 people had marched towards the military barracks on the 1st Infantry Regiment on Sunday. The regiment is an elite military unit passed under the direct command of the king. The protest march started from the Victory Monument in the capital city as people demanded the resignation of Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha and his military-supported government. Calls for change have intensified across Thailand as it has witnessed a revival of pro-democracy protests over the past 2 weeks. Sunday's protests followed news of the indefinite detention of 4 protest leaders pending trial. All 4 activists had been booked under the widely condemned Les Majestes laws, which criminalize actions perceived as an insult to the monarchy. Their bail requests were denied for the 3rd time by a criminal court in Bangkok last week. Around 58 activists have been arrested under these laws and other charges for participating in the protests in 2020. Iran has stated that it will not consider participating in talks over the nuclear deal until US-imposed sanctions are revoked. Foreign Ministry spokesperson Syed Khatibzadeh announced the decision on February 28, according to local media. A proposal for informal talks between all signatories and the US had been presented by EU Foreign Policy Chief Joseph Borrell. Former US President Trump had reimposed sanctions on Iran after unilaterally withdrawing the US from the multi-party deal in 2018. Foreign Minister Javad Zarif has stated that Iran has suffered a loss of over $1 trillion due to over 1,600 US-imposed sanctions. Iran has since stated that it will adhere to the provisions of the nuclear deal, provided all other signatories return to full compliance. This includes the limit set on uranium enrichment, as well as the additional protocol under the International Atomic Energy Agency, or the IAEA. Iran had announced that it would suspend the implementation of the protocol if the US did not remove the sanctions by February 23rd. However, the US has stated that the sanctions would be removed only once Iran complies with the deal. In the meantime, the Atomic Energy Agency has signed a temporary deal to continue the inspection of Iranian nuclear sites for the next 3 months. Iran will hold data from the agency monitoring equipment installed at its nuclear sites. The data will be released only if sanctions are removed within this period of time. For a final story of the day, we go to Haiti, where protests against imperialism and dictatorship have continued to grow. Hundreds of thousands of people have mobilized across the country to demand an end to the US-backed regime of Jovenel Moise. Here's a video feature on the ongoing protests. And that is all the time we have in this episode of the International Daily Roundup. For more such stories and videos, visit our website, peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching.